Hello and welcome to Yoga Basics. We're gonna get started. So today is, we're gonna focus on a lot of standing balancing poses, right? Focusing on our feet as our foundation, how we arrive, how we center, how we find a strength through softening. So, set up your space. And, you know, the great thing about practicing yoga at home is that you get to set up your space. We're going to start standing so you can start to find your way into a standing position. But one of our practices, which is Saucha, cleanliness, and just kind of making sure things are arranged around in your space. We're going to be doing a lot of balancing poses today. So sometimes I like to take a crystal or a stone. And I actually put the crystal or stone kind of like at the top of my mat. Because when I do my balancing poses, it'll give me something really cool to look at. It also is a nice way to kind of set your intention. So sometimes I like to do that. I like crystals and stones. If you like crystals and stones, grab one. Put it at the top of your mat. Okay. Find your feet. Feet about hip distance, toes pointing forward. Rock forward onto the balls of the feet, rock back onto the heels. And feel the arches of your feet. Notice your toes. Think about, can you lift all 10 toes and spread them? Kind of like you're starting to use your toes like talons to grip the ground. You might even put a little bounce in your knees. Then heels down, go ahead and roll to the inner edges, outer edges. Is there one ankle that has more mobility than the other? Is there one foot that has more mobility than the other? Just kind of notice, what are these feet on the ground? What are they doing? And then settling into the corners of each foot. So the ball under the big toe, the ball under the pinky toe, the center of the heel, and feel those parts of your foot really gripping the ground, then lift up through the inner arches. Bend your knees a little bit. Take your hands to your thighs. And then we're gonna straighten the knees as we encourage those quads to really engage and wrap around the front of the thighs. Yeah, take your peace fingers to your hip bones. Take a big breath. And as you exhale, just encourage the hip bones to open. Guide them upwards. Yeah, roll your shoulders back and down. And then take those arms out to your sides, Tadasana, mountain pose. Spread your fingers really wide. So we're feeling kneecaps lift. We're feeling the pelvis open, the chest lift. The arms reach out to the sides. And then focus your eyes out in front of you. Just stare at something. And imagine your head is this balloon floating right on top. And the balloon is floating upwards towards the sky. And take a big inhale through your nose, breathing through the torso. Exhale with a little bit of sound as you feel the core contract. Arriving right here. Take another big breath, pressing through your feet, lifting the kneecaps, lifting the heart. Breathing into this body in this moment as you center. Arrive and center. One more big breath. Activating the powers of your awareness. Circle the arms up overhead. Bring your palms to touch. Hands come down to your heart. Lift the elbows wide, pressing the palms together so we're spreading fingers wide. Shoulders back, chest lifts. Remember, your breath is your best tool. So breathe in through your nose. Use the torso. Fill it 360 all the way around. And then a nice noisy exhale as you feel the core draw in. Feeling into your alignment. Be gentle, but be fearless. Be fearless and be kind. And it starts right here with yourself. Let's circle those arms up overhead. Big breath. Bend your elbows. Pat yourself on the back. Shoulders down. Lift the elbows. Lift the heart. Do a little baby back bend. So it's almost like you press your head back into your arms. Open up those armpits, take a big breath. And then release the arms, bend the knees, and fold forward into Uttanasana, standing forward fold. generous bend in your knees. Trust your legs to hold you up as you shake your head yes and no. Yeah, notice your feet on the ground. Remember the point under the ball of the big toe and the ball of the pinky toe and the heel bone. Now root into those three points, keep the knees bent, and let's roll it up to standing. Pressing through the feet, your head and shoulders are the last pieces up. When you get to the top, shoulders back, head lifts, you're back in Tadasana, mountain pose. Stand tall and strong like a mountain. And as you inhale, can you lift your kneecaps, lift your heart so there's this upward energy through the front side. And then as you exhale, can you roll the shoulders down, let the tailbone drop down a bit so there's this downward energy through the backside. And you don't even really need to move, you can just feel it. Inhale, upward, lifting energy through the front. Exhale, downward, grounding energy through the back. One more time like that. Inhale, open, arrive. Exhale, ground in and center. Take those arms up overhead. Bend the elbows, pat yourself on the back. Shoulders down, lift the elbows, lift the heart, press the head back. Take a big breath. Release the arms, bend the knees, fold over. Uttanasana. Trust your legs. Trust your body. Trust your decision in being here and practicing and taking this time just for you. Keep the knees bent as you roll it up to standing. Head and shoulders are the last things up. We will meet in mountain pose, Tadasana. Take a big breath, soak it in. Know that now you come with a different purpose. You come to love. You come courageously showing up just as you are. Now, yoga is not about the poses. It's about the journey. It's about showing up. So thank you for being here. Thank you for being you. Let's circle those arms up overhead. Interlace your fingers, everything except your index fingers. So you just have this like pointer fingers sticking out. And then step your feet together. Let's put big toes touch, heels about a sliver apart. Take a second as you hug the hips together. Right, still rooting down into those three points on each foot. Draw the belly in, tuck the tail. Draw the ribs down and the shoulders down. Then the hips go over to the right. And as you kick the hips to the right, what will happen is the torso will just happen to lean to the left. You might do that a couple times. Ooh, especially because we're just getting warmed up. So you know, be gentle. Take a big breath. Draw your core in. Exhale, center. Let's do the other side. Hips kick left. You go right. And you might have to, okay, hold on. Let me see this. Feel your feet pushing into the floor. No need to overdo it. Take a breath. As you exhale, draw the belly and bring it back to center. Release the arms, separate the legs, bend the knees and dive down. Let's come up halfway lift. Hands pressing into the legs. Make sure your spine is straight, shoulders back. If you want to fly the arms back, I'm totally okay with a different variation. Yeah, but just make sure your spine is straight because that's the priority here. Take another big breath. Exhale and fold, let it go. Take it up to standing, pressing through the feet, rolling up through the spine. Circle the arms up overhead, interlace the fingers, step the feet together. Big toes touch, heels a sliver apart. Shoulders down, ribs down. Hips go over to the right. Find that side stretch. Feel how the weight transfers mostly into that right leg. Take a breath. Exhale, center. Other side, transfer the weight to the left leg. But keep that left foot planted. Don't forget about the ball of the big toes. Take your breath. Exhale, center. Open the arms, open the legs, bend the knees, and fold over. Halfway lift. Inhale. Ardha Uttanasana. You pick your arm variation. Explore your alignment. Exhale and fold. Let it go. Take it up to standing, pushing through the feet, rolling up through the spine. Circle the arms up overhead. Let's do that one more time. Step the feet together, interlace the fingers. Can you interlace the fingers so you thread them the opposite way? Thread the fingers and the thumbs the opposite way. Shoulders down, draw the ribs down. Let's go hips left and then we lean to the right first this time. Now third time we've hit this,
forward.
And let this be an invitation to explore. Take a breath. Focus your eyes out in front of you, but feel into your body. Press down into that left leg. And if you want, maybe this inside right leg kind of lifts up a little bit. Our first little balance pose here. No need to overdo it, right? Notice if you start to hold your breath, if you forget about your breath, maybe you're pushing a little too far. Let it be easy. Right? You can be soft and strong. Let's come back to center. We'll do the other side. Place that right foot down. Take a moment. Organize your pieces, and then hips go over to the right. And you side lunge. Drop the shoulders. Open up your heart. Be fearless in your commitment. Maybe you lift that inside left leg. Fearless in your commitment to cultivate an inner energy, an inner focus. Let's bring it back to center. Separate the legs, separate the arms, fold it over, dive down. Relax your head, shake your head yes, shake your head no. Come up into your halfway lift. Straight spine is the priority here. Send the hips back, reach the heart forward, and then fold it over, let it go. Take it up to standing, pushing through the feet, rolling up. Circle the arms up overhead, palms touch this time. Exhale, hands to your heart, and I want you to think of something you're grateful for. Just picture something, someone. Hands at the heart, maybe you smile a little bit and you take a breath. Now, if you're not already, let's find our way to, let's say, the top of our yoga mat, whatever that is for you. So we can continue with our sun salutes. Awesome. Circle those arms up overhead. Big breath. And we're going to sit into chair pose. So send the hips back. Sink the weight into the heels. You might even do a little bounce just to kind of get those legs to wake up a little bit more. Now, I like my legs together when I do chair. Well, at least this variation. So I'm squeezing my knees together. And that's going to like make me feel like I got this nice strong pillar. Can you draw the front of the ribs in and send that hips, those hips, that tailbone back a little more. Take another big breath. See if you can get a little lower. And then exhale and fold. Dive down over the legs. Come up into halfway lift. Inhale. Shoulders back. The priority is your spine. Exhale and fold. Take a big step back with your right foot. And we're going to go into a low lunge. Take that right knee all the way to the floor. Maybe you add a cushion under the knee. When you're ready, hands up onto your left thigh. Take a breath. Let out a noisy exhale. Draw the belly in. Tuck the tail. Put more weight into your left leg. Nice. Take those arms up overhead. Shoulders down. Lift your heart. Big breath here. Give yourself a big cactus elbow. Lift your chest. Take the arms up. Big breath. And then hands go down to the floor. If you have yoga blocks, grab a yoga block, put it under your right hand. So your right hand is on the inside of your left leg. And then we're going to twist our left arm up to the sky. Oh. Now, if you would like to, you could tuck your back toes and lift your back knee off the floor. But I want you to be aware of your hips here. Yeah, so can you pull your left hip back a little bit? And your right hip forward, so the hips are now squared. Can you lengthen your spine and then twist from your rib cage? And make sure your left hand in the sky is in your eye line. All right, so you should be able to see your left arm. Take a breath. Bring that left arm down to the floor, both hands on the mat. We're going back into down dog. Now, if you need to, you can transition through tabletop first, place your hands, then find down dog. However you need to make that transition happen for you. Now here, our hands are our foundation. So we need big starfish hands. And we want to feel that energy coming through the hands into the elbows. Hug the elbows in. All the way into the shoulders. Imagine you had eyeballs in your shoulders. In your armpits, I'm sorry. Eyeballs in your armpits. You're trying to get those eyeballs to start to look at each other. So wrap the shoulder blades around the outsides of the armpits. And then can you draw the rib cage, those lower ribs in, and flare the tailbone up? It's okay to bend the knees. It's okay to wiggle the hips. Let's try to create some length through our spine first. Relax your head. Take another big breath. Walk your feet a little closer together and take your right leg up to the sky for down dog splits. Reach that right heel up. And then bring that right leg all the way through. Plant it in between your hands. Let's go low lunge, other side. Left knee goes down. Take a moment when you're ready. Hands up on your right thigh. Make sure you're pressing down into that front right leg. Lots of energy in that front leg. Draw the navel in, tailbone down. We still want to get our ribs stacked over our hips here. And then when you feel good, you take those arms up. But remember, you're in charge. You listening to your body is what's most important. So notice all the parts of you that touch the ground. How do you use the ground? And then how do you draw that energy up from the through the legs, into the hips, into the core? Give yourself a big cactus elbow when you're ready. Lift your heart to the sky. Take those arms up. Hands to the floor, maybe a yoga block under your left hand. We're going to twist it out. Right arm goes up. Checking in with your hips. Maybe you pull that right hip back a little bit. And then can you lengthen the spine? Take a breath. Are you still putting a lot of weight into your right foot? Please do. And we don't want too much weight in the left hand. Maybe come up onto your left fingertips. Let the weight be in the legs here. Take a breath. Open your heart. And then the right hand comes down to the floor. Let's step up into a forward fold. So stepping up into our forward fold, placing the feet, and finding Uttanasana. Oh. Take a breath. Come up into Ardha Uttanasana, halfway lift. Shoulders back. Exhale, fold it over. Take it up to standing, pressing through the feet, rolling up through the spine, circle the arms up overhead, palms touch. Exhale, hands to your heart. Take a full breath cycle here. Pause for a moment. Arms reach up, find Utkatasana, which is our chair pose. Nice. So starting into this other side to finish our sun salute. Take a breath. Get low, get low. Take a breath. Nice. One more right here. Exhale and fold. Let it go. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale and fold. So since we stepped back with our right foot first last time, we're going to step back with our left leg first this time. So left leg back. All right, bending into that right knee and coming up high lunge. Now, if you prefer the back knee down, you can keep the back knee down. You get to choose. Draw the belly in. Make sure the hips are under the rib cage. Lift your heart. Take a breath. And when you're ready, cactus arms. Take those arms up. Big breath. Hands down to the floor, maybe a yoga block under your left hand. Right arm twists open, just like we did on the other side. We're doing the same moves. How can you find more length? How can you really allow your legs to use the ground? Let your legs be the support. One more breath here, and then the right arm comes down, and I'll meet you in down dog, however you would like to transition. Remember, arrive and center with every breath. Be gentle and fearless. Breathe, relax, and feel into the body. Start to walk your legs together, and we're going to take the left leg up to the sky now. Reach it high. Find that separation between the legs and then bring it all the way through and plant it in between your hands. Getting ready for your lunge. If you want the back knee down, you can put it down or keep it up. Arms and torso come up when you're ready. And focusing your eyes. Letting your awareness do the work. Noticing if there's areas where you tend to be a little over-aggressive. And how can you be soft and strong? Take a big breath, and when you're ready, cactus arms, lift your heart. Nice. Take those arms up, and then hands to the floor. Maybe a yoga block under your right hand. Getting ready for your twist. Find your expansion. Make those little micro adjustments. Play with it. Get curious. Left arm comes down and then step up. Uttanasana, standing forward fold. Completing that sun salute. Relax your head. Shake it out. Come up into halfway lift. Inhale. Exhale, forward fold. Take it up to standing, pressing through the feet, rolling up through the spine. Circle the arms up overhead. Big breath. Palms touch. Exhale, hands to your heart. We're here for three breaths. Just stand. Focus your eyes on something specific. Just feel your heart beating. The energy tingling, vibrating. Aware of everything, but attached to nothing. The slow rhythm of your breath. Constantly keeping you tied to the present moment. Now let's take ourselves into more of the coronal plane, the frontal plane. We're going to go wide on the mat. Yes, you find your prasarita, wide legs. All right, take the hands to the hips and then your right toes. We're going to pivot the right toes out. Getting ready for a warrior two. Go ahead and bend into that right knee and then straighten that right leg. And as you bend and straighten that right knee, I want you to really be aware of this back left leg. And we want the back left leg to be this strong anchor. So the outer edge of that left foot is sealed into the mat. The inner arch of the left foot is trying to lift. Yeah, and then bending into this right knee. Think about the outer side of this left leg is drawing down towards the outer edge of the foot, while the inner arch and the inner line of the leg is drawing upwards towards the pelvic floor, right? There's some kinetic chain energy right there. Feel the glute activate, strong thigh. Now checking in with this right knee, make sure your right knee is reaching out towards your pinky toes. Now you really got to use those muscles to pull the legs apart. When you're ready, arms out to the sides. Let's go palms up and imagine that you're holding heavy trays of drinks in each hand. You might need to bend your elbows a little bit so that we can get this contraction of the tricep, the armpit muscles. Lift your heart. Nice. Look forward past your right middle finger. And then turn the head to look behind you. Look over the left arm. And then turn the head to look over the right arm. Take a breath. And turn the head to look over the left arm. Inhale, look forward over the right arm. Exhale, look back over that left arm. Inhale, go ahead and look forward, and let's reverse this warrior. So left arm down the back left leg, right arm goes up. Lead with your right elbow. In fact, bend your right elbow. Bring your right arm behind your head. Try to get your nose to your right elbow. Checking in with the legs, are they still in the same spot? Do you still feel the engagement? Can you draw your pelvic floor up and in? Draw your core in and lift your heart. Take a breath. Go ahead and release back into Virabhadrasana 2, Warrior 2. Then Parsva Konasana, our extended side angle. So reaching that right arm forward, dropping the right arm on the inside of the right thigh. Left arm goes up and over. Yeah, beautiful. Find your expression. If you're ready to take both arms up, you're feeling it, go ahead and do it. Totally. Feel those obliques wrapping around the trunk because the legs are so strong here. Right, so now you can find all this length through the sides of the trunk. Open your heart, take a breath, and then bring it back up. Virabhadrasana 2. Straighten that right leg. Pivot those right toes in. Take your right arm in front of you. Bend the elbow. Left elbow hooks underneath. And you can either take a shoulder stretch, which looks like this, or you can go for Garudasana arms, which are eagle arms. Okay, so you just take whatever variation you need. What we want to try to do is get the left elbow to hook underneath that right arm. All right, bend the knees. So make sure your feet are parallel. Feet are parallel. Bend the knees. We're going to fold over the legs. You can gently sway the arms a little side to side, like you're drawing a figure eight or an infinity sign with your elbows. Now take a big breath. Bend the knees. Inhale, come on up. Lift those elbows and then release the arms. Whew. All right, hands to the hips, pivot the left toes out, bend and straighten that left knee. And I want you to notice your hips. So if your pelvis, it's a bowl, right? Like a bowl of cereal, right? That's what your hands right here. You're on the sides of the bowl of cereal. And we want to make sure that we're not spilling our bowl. And so I'm trying to just work with whatever range of motion I have in my hip joint while trying to keep my bowl level, right? Not dropping. I'm not trying to tilt the left side of my bowl out. I'm not trying to dump it forward or dump it back. I'm trying to keep it level while I open up my legs. And then bending into that left knee, feel outer thighs. Wiggle your toes, take a breath. When you're ready, arms out to the sides. Let's go palms down. And imagine you're pressing your palms down on two countertops. Pressing down. Lift your heart. See if you can get that isometric contraction through the triceps and the armpit muscles. Take a big breath. Look forward past your left arm. Just feel into your body. Find a moment of stillness here. A moment of surrender. That doesn't mean that you're stiff like a statue. Just a moment where you're just choosing to stay engaged no matter what. Breathing like the warrior that you are. Palms flip up and Viparita Virabhadrasana, which is your reverse warrior. Right arm down that back leg, left arm up. Bend the elbow, hand behind the head. Notice if you have a tendency to create compression through this right side, right? We kind of tend to dump back there. I don't want you to dump back there. I want you to lift. Yeah, that's why lifting with the elbow sometimes will help with that. Take a breath. Bring the arms back, Virabhadrasana 2. Extended side angle, Parsva Konasana. Left arm on the inside of that left leg, right arm up and over. Nice. Check in with your feet. Are you still lifting inner arches? Think about that pyramid on the bottom of each foot. Draw it up. Take another big breath. Draw your core in. If you want both arms to reach out, you can. Can you find a way to let this be effortless? Can you soften the edges and work from a deeper place? It's okay to wiggle it out, especially if things get crampy. One more breath. All right, bring it back up. Virabhadrasana 2 as you straighten that left leg. Pivot the left toes in. Let's find those eagle arms. Left elbow bends in front. Right elbow goes underneath. You can take a shoulder stretch or you can double wrap. Shoulders down, lift the elbows. Forearms away from your face and then bend the knees and fold. Take a big breath. Maybe sway side to side. You find what feels good. Yoga is an invitation to explore. It's not a performance. It's not commands. It's the flow of your breath in motion. Bend the knees, inhale, come on up. The formless taking form within you. Reach those arms out, give them a little shake. Woo-hoo-hoo. All right, step the feet in. And let's go back to the top of our mat. And if you have yoga blocks, you can have those yoga blocks set up right at the top of your mat for you. Now we're going to step our feet together. Take our hands to prayer at our hearts. And focus our eyes out in front of us. Just pick a focal point. Take a breath. Draw the belly in. Press down into the right leg. Left knee lifts up. So starting with big toe balance, which is, we're going to do a variation of big toe balance here. Now take your left hand to your left knee. Yeah, and then open your right arm out to the right side. You might need to bend that standing right knee a little bit. Right, remain suggestible. You're more like a plant than you are like a statue. So growing with every breath. And if it feels appropriate, you could take that left knee out to the left side. Now, do you have energy through the whole kinetic chain of that left leg? Okay, what are you doing with that left foot? Energy, energy. Take a breath. And then bring that left knee back to center if you moved it out. And we're going to kick that left leg back, going into Virabhadrasana 3. And you could do whatever you want with your arms. Focus your eyes. Now, when we get into these balancing series, if you fall out, you can always come back in. You find your expression. Remember, be gentle and fearless. Let's take our hands down to the ground, or if we have yoga blocks, this is the spot to put our hands on those yoga blocks. But we want the weight to stay in the right leg. So just because my hands are on the ground doesn't mean I'm dumping my weight into my arms. But I want my hands or my yoga blocks to be nice and close to my right foot. Standing splits. Take a breath. And then melt your chest towards the top of your right foot as you actively lift the left leg up to the sky. So my left leg's kicking up, so my chest melts down. And if you want more, take your right hand, grab your right ankle. Focus your eyes. Even here, focus on the floor, just one little speck of dust. Take a big breath. Bend that right knee. Bring that left leg down to meet it, back into forward fold. Separate the legs. Come up halfway lift, inhale, so we're at the top of our mats. Exhale and fold, whoo. Take it up to standing, pressing through the feet, rolling up. Arms circle up overhead, palms touch, hands to the heart. Take a moment to soak in the buzz, to slow down the exhale. Then walk the feet together, because we're gonna do the other side. Pressing down into that left leg now, and the right leg lifts. So feel this pushing down through left leg, right leg lifting, right? This energy going through in both directions. Right hand to the right knee, left arm can open out. Now you can stay here. Or you can open that knee out to the side. And we're holding that right leg up on its own, right? My right arm is just here for support. If you want to challenge yourself and look over that left shoulder, you can. Variation of our big toe balance. Take a breath. Bring it back to center. And we're practicing ninja skills here. So take a moment, refocus, and when you're ready, you kick that right leg back and your torso will lean forward. And this is going to look different for all of us. It is 100% okay if you need the back right toes on the floor. And you just play with kind of putting them down and lifting them up. You pick your variation. What's your back foot doing? Is it active? Make sure it's active. Kick through that heel. Get the muscles around the entire part of the hip, the glutes, the front of the legs, the core. Support the hips, hug them together. Take a breath. And when you're ready, take the arms down to blocks or the floor standing splits. But I really want you to keep your hips squared. Nice fix, Marla. Yeah, you don't want to pop that back hip. I want you to keep the toes pointed down. There's energy through that back leg. You got to lift it up. You got to use the muscles on the back of that leg. Maybe bend the standing left leg. Reach your heart towards the foot. Make sure the weight is in the leg. We're almost there. Take a breath. Maybe left hand grabbing left ankle. Keep energy in that back leg. Lift it up, lift it up. And then slowly we release, bending the left knee. Bring the right leg down. Separate the legs so they're about, hip distance, maybe wider. And then come up into halfway lift. Inhale. Exhale and fold. Take it all the way up to standing, pressing through the feet. When you get to the top, circle the arms up overhead, palms touch, hands come to your heart. Take a moment to pause. Feel both feet pressing into the floor. Breathe that energy up through the feet, up through the legs, into the hips, up through the belly, into your heart, your throat, your third eye, and out the crown of your head. Let's circle the arms up overhead. Take a big breath. Bend the knees and dive down. Take the hands to the mat. Step back. Find a plank position. Now your hands are your foundation here. Big starfish gecko hands. And lean to the right. And then lean to the left. Maybe even pick up your hand and put it back down. And what is it like to pick them up and replace them down? Can I stretch the webbing in between each finger? Can I really use each fingertip and create a suction cup sensation through the center of my palms? Yeah, and then can you hug your elbows in and reach your chest forward, but draw the front of the ribs in, right? This whole kinetic chain. Take a big breath. Down dog, send the hips up. And take a big breath. Let out a big cleansing exhale. Slowly take the knees down to the floor. Balasana, child's pose. Make sure the forehead rests. And take a moment. Be strong and fearless in your knowing that now you have a new purpose. With all these awarenesses, all this knowledge, now compassion is part of the mission. You can let it flow and let it go. Let's come up into tabletop. And we're going to take our right foot and take it into low lunge. So right foot outside of the right hand. And we're going into half pigeon. Okay. So from here, we're going to heel toe the right foot. And I'll face this way. Heel toe the right foot over towards the left hand. That's where we start. And then I want you to flex your right toes up towards your face. So you're locking out the right ankle. And that's important because locking out the right ankle is going to protect your knee. And then you're going to let your right knee come forward and down. I'm going to take a moment here. Now, if you have two yoga blocks, I would love for you to put the yoga blocks under your hands, propping your torso up a little bit. So I'm using my arms to kind of lift myself out of my legs so I can adjust and make sure both of my hips are facing forward. And it's okay if your hands are on the ground. That is totally fine, too. Now, if this is bothering your knees, if this feels painful, right, the alternative here would be to lay on your back and do figure four. And so just know that that is available to you too. Now, in half pigeon, let's make sure that our right knee is out to the side. That's really, I want to abduct my right femur. I want to take it out to the side a little bit and make sure my hips are facing forward. Nice. And this is a back bend, so draw your belly and lengthen your tailbone down. Make sure that left leg behind you is kind of reaching back. You might even kind of give it a little scoot back. If you're in figure four, you're taking that stretch wherever you need it to go. And now, those of us still in half pigeon, if you would like to take the arms forward, I like to take my yoga blocks under my elbows and enjoy the hip stretch. Absolutely take it there. And if you need cushion or pillows, a nice wedge under this right hip so that you feel more supported, add that. Breathe. Soften. And feel the body receive its truth. Trust can be one of your superpowers, along with your awareness, along with your breath. If you're in half pigeon, we're going to slowly come up to our hands. If you're in figure four on your back, stay on your back because we're just going to switch sides. So to get out of this half pigeon, we come up onto our hands, tuck the back toes, lift the hips, and take that right leg back. So we're back. And you might take it down dog if down dog is something that feels good for you. Take your time. When you're ready, left leg outside of the left hand. So we're going to switch sides. Take a breath. Draw the belly in, reach the heart forward. And then heel toe the left foot over towards the right hand. Lock out that left ankle as you bring the knee forward and down. And we just want to make sure the left femur is abducting, is it being taken away from the hip at some sort of angle. Yeah, adjust your arms, lift your heart, find a back bend first. And notice as soon as you lift your sternum up away from your pubic bone, this right hip flexor gets this amazing stretch. Make sure that right leg is kind of stretching back behind you. And then you get to decide where you take your, where you take it from here. Let your intuition guide you. Three more breaths, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, whatever you are exploring. And let your yoga coax you out of the confines of what you know. Be courageous as you move across the threshold into expansiveness, into unlimited possibilities. Into resilience, longevity. Finishing that last breath, finding your way out. Be really mindful as you come out of this. Ooh. If you're on your back at figure four, go ahead and meet us in tabletop position. And if you want to shake it out, if you feel like a down dog is going to help you hit the reset button, feel free to take it. Take a breath. And we are all going to meet in a seated position. So finding a seated position, I recommend getting a sitting pillow or a sitting cushion. A new body position, new point of awareness. Take a moment. And we are going to go into full pigeon. So I want you to bring your left shin down in front of you, and you're going to lock out that left ankle, right? Just that right there, that brightness in the ankle, is just helps protect the knees. And then take your right leg, and you're going to take that right ankle and stack it right on top of that left knee. Whew. Now, the more like fire logs we stack our shins, the more intense it is. The more you slide your heels towards your hips, the less intense it'll be. Now, you might hold on to this right leg. And it's going to look different for all of us. Wherever you are. And if this is also, if this is feeling very unacceptable, you can't really access this, it's okay. Maybe the bottom leg needs to go straight. And maybe you just try this. And you can even, if your bottom leg is straight, you can even lift up this right shin and kind of play with that. But let's check in with the spine. Let's make sure we're sitting up tall. And if you need more, if you're sitting here and you're like, Jess, this feels easy. Whew, yeah. Start to lean forward. Ooh, that's how we would add a little more intensity there. You get to play with it. I invite you to close your eyes. To let go of the supposed to's. And just be where you are. And if you need to adjust and find a different stretch that feels really good for you right now, that's okay too. Yoga's about listening. The union is something you create. Now, in poses like this, what we're really doing is we're putting our bones in certain positions that where we feel the tension on the muscles. Right, so I'm putting my joints, and I'm going to find a tension that feels doable for me, but it still feels like a stretch. Right, so your own appropriate edge. And the more you stack ankle on top of knee and knee on top of ankle, create these kind of fire logs, you can play with different angles that help you find your appropriate edge. And then when you're at that edge, you breathe and you soften. You think about those tissues around those joints softening. And give it some space and time. Go ahead and release this side. Lean back a little bit. uncross that top leg, bottom leg, and then turn the toes in and out. Whew. Shake them out. And then we're going to do the other side. So the right leg folds in. And if this is feeling really easy, try your feet a little further away. And then we cross. Oh my goodness. Yeah, sitting up tall. And you have to just find what works for you. It's okay if it's more of like a cross-legged position. Right, that's okay. Right, find your appropriate edge. And one side might feel totally different than the other. And then sit up tall. Take a breath. Drop the shoulders, open your heart, soften your face. If you need more intensity, you can lean forward a little bit. You get to play here. Yeah, and sometimes elevating the hips a little more, if we're struggling here, getting the hips even higher might be helpful. That's something we can play with too. Like I have this thick bolster here. And if I get my hips up on the bolster, I have a little more access into what I do with my hips. So if you're out there and just want to try something else. Oh God. If you haven't already, I invite you to close your eyes. Take a big breath down into a soft belly. Let out a slow exhale. This is me tuning in to a frequency that allows me to receive. This is me letting myself off the hook. Reminding myself that I don't have to have all the answers. That where I am is exactly where I need to be. Take one more big breath. Nice long exhale. And we're gonna release this, carefully coming up and leaning back. Go slow, one part at a time. We'll get off of our sitting cushions. Scoop forward on your yoga mat. Make sure you got space behind you. If you have a yoga block, you could take your yoga block, put it in between your thighs. Sitting up tall, reaching the arms forward, taking a breath, and then exhale, rolling down. Take your time. Pause when you get to a sticky point and take a breath, breathing into the back and sides of the ribs, and then exhale and roll back a little bit more. And maybe one more time. Eventually laying down on your back, stretching your arms up over your head, rolling your wrists and your ankles. Then bring your right knee into your chest and give that right knee a hug. And take a big breath. And bring your chin down so the back of the neck is long. Then open the right arm out to the right side and twist that leg up and over to the left. Maybe give your hips a little scoot over to the right. Please check in with your right hip. Let's make sure the right hip is lengthening down away from the right rib. Lots of length through the lumbar spine. Look over that right shoulder, relax that right shoulder. It's okay to bend that bottom left knee if you need to, absolutely. Where can you soften? Slowly untwist, come back to center. Give both of your knees a hug, reset your spine. Then hold the left knee in, extend the right leg. Feel the length from your right heel all the way up to the back of your neck. Take a breath. And when you're ready, start to find your twist. Making any adjustments that you need. And sometimes when I do this twist, once I twist my left leg across, then I think about my rib cage lifting up away from my hips, lengthening it, and then my head lifting up away from my ribs. We just always want to be creating space, creating opportunity. Take one more big breath. Slowly untwist and come back to center. Give your knees a hug. Reset the spine. If it feels good, lift your head up like you're going to kiss your knees. So you're squeezing yourself like a little ball. Take a breath. And then release yourself into Shavasana. Now, if you want, you could use your blocks or pillows underneath your knees. Sometimes that feels better for the lower back. You could also do Shavasana with your knees bent. If your knees are bent, make sure your feet are wide and let the knees fall together. Just like any pose, we've got to set this one up to fit our bodies. Make sure the lower back is long. Get your shoulders out of your ears. Bring your chin down so the back of the neck is long. And then take a breath. Feel the breath going down into a soft belly. And as you exhale, relax your bones. Let the body get heavy. Feel this field of awareness, field of sensation. Soften the back of your eyes, your eyelids, the sides of your eyes. Let your vision drop inward. Soften the inner space of the body. and sink into stillness for just a few moments. gently guide your awareness to your breath. No need to change it, just notice it. Then guide your awareness to the back of your body and all the parts of you that touch the ground. And the front of the body and all the parts of you that open upward, the space around you. And taking a big belly breath in. Nice long exhale out. Gathering all your awareness antennas. Start to wiggle the fingers and the toes. Feeling the subtle cues. Being patient. You might rock your head side to side. When you're ready, starting to bend the knees. Taking your time as you roll over onto your favorite side. And then finding your way up to a seated position. Get comfortable in your seated position. Maybe propping the hips up. And taking a big breath. And slowing down the exhale. And again, with your right hand, make a hang loose sign. Take your thumb to your right nostril. Plug your right nostril. Inhale through the left. Then switch, plug the left, open the right, exhale right. Then inhale right. Switch, exhale left. Inhale left. Switch and exhale right. Inhale right. Switch and exhale left. Do that a few more times. This alternate nostril breathing, Nadi Shodhana. Soften your jaw. Just streamline that air in through one nostril, out through the other. And finish with an exhale out your right nostril. Once you're done, bring your palms together, hands at your heart, Anjali Mudra. Take a few breaths through, in and out through both nostrils. Allow the corners of your mouth to curl up to your ears. And practice some gratitude. Tell yourself thank you. Thank you for showing up. Thank you for this gift. Thank you, body. I'm listening. As you breathe in, let that gratitude soak into every cell of the body. Thank you so much for sharing this space with me, sharing your practice with me. And from my heart to yours, namaste. Hmm.